Hello everyone. This video is about introduction to LAMP stack and the programming language PHP. So what is a LAMP stack? A stack is a set of software tools which enable us to develop web applications. So this is basically equivalent to a framework where it provides for design and development of web services or your web applications. In simple terms, a website in a very user-friendly manner. So in order to develop a website or a web application, what do we require? So basically, a website is a collection of web pages or web sources. So in order to design and develop web pages, we require certain software tools. So a web application can be developed with the help of two different set of interfaces, one at the front end and others at the back end. So the front-end user interface is basically a web page or a web document, which can be designed and developed using certain programming languages such as JavaScript. And at the back end, we have a set of software which are basically related to the servers. So in order to store data on the computer or onto the requested interface, you require a database server. And along with the database server, you require a certain software tools which enable us to send the responses for the requests that are made from the user. Basically, these are being serviced with the help of a web server. So a web server is basically a software which enables us to provide the responses that are being requested from the user. In order to interact with the database server and the web server, you require a programming language which supports us to have some communication between the servers so that whatever the requests that are being made by the user or from the different clients can be easily served with the help of the certain software tools. So a combination of a database server along with the web server and a programming language, we usually term it as a combination or a collection of software tools which provides us a framework for managing and trying to provide the responses to the users for various web requests. So these software tools or the collection of these servers, it depends on the operating system which we are using it on a server or a computer which stores or which provides the facility to host these servers. So that particular computer, if the computer or a workstation or a server, which provides certain facilities to manage and maintain the web requests, it always depends on the operating system, which caters to the needs of various users. So the operating systems such as Linux, Windows, Mac operating system, these are the common operating systems which are well known for the various users. So if at all you are using on the server which hosts these different servers, so if the Linux is the operating system on the host computer, you can have other combinational tools which help us to provide that framework. Usually we call it as a LAMP. So L stands for Linux. Similarly, if you are hosting this web server, that is your Apache, and your database server, if it is your MySQL server or MySQL server, and if you're using a programming language as a PHP, hypertext preprocessor, on a Windows operating system, we call that particular stack to be as a VAMP. And similarly, if you're running this web server, MySQL server, and the programming language on a Mac operating system, on a Mac computers, we call it as a MAMP. Suppose if you want to run your these software stack or your a database server, web server, and the programming languages on a distributed computing environment or on cross platforms, we call it as a XAMPP. So in addition to these, you also have PHP. In addition to PHP, we also have other programming language tool called Perl. So this XAMPP supports PHP as well as Perl programming language. So it provides some server-side scripting tools enable us to do the server-side functionalities. So if you look to the client-server model, a client is person which requests. So the requests are coming from your client side with the help of the web browser application. So on the browser, you are going to run a web interface or a web page or a web resource. So those requests are coming from the client and they are being sent to the server. So in turn, the server gives the responses for the various requests that are coming from the different set of clients. So these stacks will be helpful for us to design and develop various websites and web applications in a very easy manner and easy to maintain. So in this present study, I will be focusing on the LAMP stack. And similarly, if other students who are very much interested on Windows or Mac, you can follow the same similar set of steps for installing and managing and maintaining those websites. So in order to install your LAMP stack, I have given you the video. Separate video has been recorded and it has been made available on the Moodle website. So you can follow the basic steps to install your web server, that is your Apache, and the database server to store your data, that is your MySQL, and the programming language PHP. So you can follow these simple steps on your Linux operating system, which will provide to maintain your web services or web applications. In simple terms, the websites. So this stack is a combination of these software tools which enable us to develop your website and maintain the website in a more easy manner. So once you have completed this installation of your LAMP stack, you can check whether your LAMP stack components have been installed properly or not by issuing the commands at the shell prompt. So I'll just show you how to invoke your LAMP stacks. So these are the steps you need to check for. So let us open. So let me open my VirtualBox. And this is Oracle VirtualBox. So then, of course, I have different software tools here. One such is FogOne. Do not confuse with the name here. Just the name of the computer is FogOne here. So on this computer, I have installed the Ubuntu 18.04 and the LAMP stack has been installed. So let the system be up. In a couple of minutes, the system gets up. Then once it is up, we can check the various commands. So in meantime, so let us look for the commands to be issued to make sure that your LAMP stack is installed properly and ready to use. So here, so the first command to check whether you have installed the PHP properly or not, you can issue the command php space hyphen small v to check the version number of the PHP if it is installed. So it will display what is the version which you have installed on the PHP. Then the second command you need to look for is the MySQL. So you can log in with your super user or it's up to you. So once you have logged in at the terminal prompt, that is at the shell prompt, you can type the command MySQL space hyphen small u space root space hyphen small p, which enables me to log in as a root user for this database. So once you log in, so you should be able to see the MySQL prompt, which tells us that your MySQL is ready to use at this particular command prompt. So it implies that your MySQL is also been installed here. And the last step which you need to check yourself is on your web browser, you are going to issue a localhost server. So you just at the URL type http://, then followed by localhost. So once you type, you should get some response of your web server, either your Apache web server or your PHP information page, or if you have customized your index page or your home page, you should see some message. So once you press enter, you should be able to see some response. So if it is showing something, means you already made ready your web server to give the respective responses. So once these three commands are done, then it implies that your LAMP stack is ready to use for you to design and develop your websites, that is your web applications. So let me log in to my virtual machine. This is, yeah. So once you logged in, of course, this is the Ubuntu server version. Yeah, you can go to the terminal prompt. So at the terminal prompt, as I mentioned, let us check the PHP version, PHP. Let me zoom in so that we can view the screen properly. I hope you're able to see the commands. Yes. So once you zoom in, now I'm issuing the command. So once you get a response like this, PHP space hyphen small v, you should be able to see PHP, the version number 7.2 is installed here on Ubuntu 18.04 operating system. So it means your PHP is running. Similarly, now you log in to your root user. So once you log into your root user, you should be able to see the hash prompt here. So at the hash prompt, type the command mysql hyphen u, the user is root. So prompt for the password. Yes, now it asks for the password. Now you enter the password for the root user of the database. Now you should be able to see the mysql prompt. So once you get the mysql prompt, you can issue the SQL commands, that is your MySQL commands, something like show the existing databases, followed by semicolon. Yes, you should get some responses here. It means the MySQL is now installed correctly here. You can exit from your MySQL database server and come back to your shell prompt. Now you can open a browser. So you can go to the browser which is available on your system. So in my computer, because it is server version, I have installed a lightweight browser is installed, lightweight browser. This name is Dilo. So at the URL, I am typing http localhost. Once you get some response, yes, it means your Apache web server is also working fine. So the three tools, the Apache, the database server MySQL, and the PHP, all are working fine here. Right. So this implies that your LAMP stack is ready to use. So let us now understand how do we write programs using this LAMP stack. So in order to write these programs for your designing and developing your web pages, the programming language what we are using is the PHP. PHP stands for PHP stands for Hypertext Preprocessor. Is basically a programming language that allows the developers to create the dynamic content that interacts with various databases which are at the server side. So PHP is basically a server-side scripting language. So this server-side scripts will be embedded onto your HTML scripts in order to manage the dynamic contents, the databases, the sessions trackings, and of course the entire, you can develop your e-commerce websites using the PHP itself. So if you look to the syntax of the PHP programming language, it's more similar to your C programming language syntax. So you start with the simple examples, then we will understand what are the functions and how do we make use of this PHP for various purposes. So let us see a small example. Example one is just basically your HTML file. So these HTML tags have been used to inform that your title of your web page is something like example one PHP. So inside the body tags, we are using two tags here. One tag is your heading tag H2, which states that it is welcome to server side programming using PHP, and followed by you are using another tag here. So these tags are being very much different from your normal HTML tags. So the opening tag here, which indicates with a question mark followed by your PHP. So the open tag indicates that you are going to write a PHP scripts, which have been embedded until your closing tag of the corresponding tag of the PHP. So here we have, usually we use, if you are looking for ASP.NET, you might have seen the server side programming usually use percentage symbols, which always the tags with certain special characters like percentages, at the rates, or question marks implies that most of those tags are going to be running at the server sides. So those statements or those commands or those tags are going to be executed more on your server side. So here in this, the server side scripting language is PHP. So the syntax here you need to follow is in the opening tag, you should have a question mark followed by PHP in small letters, then followed by the appropriate statements which are related to your PHP programming language. Here I'm using an echo statement, which is more similar to your print statement, like you're printing a particular statement onto your web browser here. So the web browser is the one which you are displaying it on your body tag. So the body tag of your web page contains a statement to be printed, such as hello world. So there are two statements here. One is your heading, and the other statement is your PHP statement, the hello world. So this PHP is the tag which has been embedded in your body tag of your HTML. So PHP allows us that these statements are going to be run on your on the server side. So let us write this small program here. So in order to write this your PHP scripts, so you need to be running these scripts on your server side. So go to your server PHP, then open a VA editor and type the particular code here which embeds your PHP. So here in this, when you type in the program, so make sure that all your scripts, PHP scripts, are going to be stored on your server. So here to store this PHP scripts on your server. This is my virtual machine. So you can store your programs on the path here. So to see where your document roots or your documents are consisting on your web server, you need to check the path. So in order to check the path, you can look for this, where your documents are going to be available. So on the localhost, you can type php.inf, or you can go to your the path here. So look for the path. So you are on the home directory. So you need to come out of this home directory. So then all your documents are going to be available on the root directory, that is your www, so World Wide Web documents, that you're going to keep it on your web server. So you can go to that using changing path. You can go to WAR directory. Under the WAR, you have something you can check here. So under the WAR directory, you have www. So you need to go into the directory.
So once you go into the directory www, there is a folder called HTML. So all your documents can be stored under this folder. So now your path is var www.html. So under this folder, HTML folder, you can create your own folder or your another subdirectory to store your different project files. So you can open something like WixPI example1.php. So your all PHP files will have an extension .php, which implies that there is a PHP script on your that particular document. So once you open here, so you can, I will open this using an editor. So you can enter the HTML code. So I'm inserting a title, followed by your body tag. Inside the body tag, giving in heading, some heading you can give it here, close the heading tag, then followed by you can start typing your PHP. So you are going to type ? Followed by PHP, something like you are using a print statement which is equivalent to echo. So this is my PHP program. So all your PHP statements will be ended with a semicolon. And please remember, PHP is a case sensitive. Case sensitive means there is a difference between your small case letters and your uppercase letters. So please be careful. There is a different meaning for these letters and the characters. So once you just type the statements which are related to your logic of your program using your PHP, you can close the PHP tag using ? Followed by the greater than symbol, then you close the body tag, then you close your HTML tag, then you save your file. So you have saved it using ex1.php. So this ex1.php, if you see what are all the files here in this folder, so you have different files here. The example one, something like this. So these are the files. So we have something like example1.php, index.html. So by default, index.html page is going to be executed here. So you can see these are the files. Then info.php, you'll get the information here. So let us now run this ex1.php on your local host server, ex1.php. So this is my first PHP program. This is the heading which you are seeing here. So on the title, you can see welcome to PHP. This is the heading. This is first PHP program. And this is the this is my PHP program is a statement which is being printed using the echo statement of your PHP. So now once you have executed this, you can also see what is the present configurational or your present environmental setup using info.php. So here info.php always will give you the PHP version followed by what are all the configurations you have made. So where your files are getting stored. So and whether your database is connected to your parser, PHP parser or not. So you can see, you can access these your web pages using the localhost IP address 127.0.0.1. followed by the Apache environment. So you can access this, the HTTP using the, that's what we are doing here, localhost. So your server
address is also can also be used, the IP address 127.0.0.1, and your document routes path is being specified in WHERE WWHTML. So whenever you change your document routes, accordingly you have to put all your web pages at that particular source. So these are how you are going to execute your PHP programs on the server. So let us see now what are the other programs that you can execute here. So let us start with how the PHP program can be used. What are the how to use the variables and what are the various operators this PHP supports. So always your variables in the PHP scripts are going to be prefixed with the dollar symbol. So dollar followed by your the identifier, something like your variable names. So it will hold temporary values here. So always your PHP is going to identify that there anything which is been prefixed with dollar symbol implies that it is very basically a variable. So you need not specify the data types. So the values which you assign to that particular variables will automatically assign that particular corresponding data type to that particular or variable. So it can be integers, it can be doubles, it can be boolean values, so on and so forth. Similarly, what you are using in the C programming language, it also applies, the same rules applies for this, but make sure that these variables are being prefixed with dollar symbol. So in this example, you are assigning two values, one for the variable dollar first and another for the dollar second. So and these two variables have been summed up, so you're using an arithmetic operator plus symbol. So automatically these particular integer values are going to be summed up and the value is going to be stored in another third variable. And you're using the echo, like your printf statement of your C is here, you're using the echo statement. Here the echo statement is given with a literal string that is within the quotes, which implies that the output statement should be having the statement sum is equal to, followed by the dot operator, which is using the concatenation operator, which is used to display the value of the third variable. So the third variable is being addressed, or the third variable is being referred with the dollar symbol. So all these statements are being embedded in the tags of the opening PHP tag and the corresponding closing tag. So and this PHP script can be easily embedded onto your body of your HTML pages. Now this is how you can use the variables here. Similarly, you can use the other operators such as modulus operator to get the remainder value. And you can also use your HTML tags along with the PHP tags like this within the quotes, within the double quotes, it implies that you are using a break tag to be displayed onto the next line, or the output to be displayed onto the next line. Similarly, you can have your conditional statements like your C programming. You can use your if else statements. So all your conditional statements, your switch cases, you can use it. Similarly, you can use the other operators, logical operators. You can use it, arithmetic operators, you can use assignment operators, all remains the same, which are most equivalent to your C programming language style. So this is another example where you are assigning two different values, such as these are string values here, basically. So you can have a variable name as username and you are assigning a string value here. Similarly, another variable is that you pass like a password for the user, you are assigning another value here. So you are checking the values, the username is equal to ABCD, or the logical or operator is also coming here, or user password is equal to ABCD. Then you are going to, if the condition is, if you can put both the conditions has to be checked, then you can put AND here, the logical AND. Otherwise you can use the OR condition. And in the PHP also supports to go to a particular page. So that page, to redirect from a particular page to another page, you can use the header function, which will make you to locate to another page, such as relogin.php to another, you can navigate to another page here. So this else statement, you can say that it is an invalid name or an invalid username or a password. So like this, you can use the conditional statements in the PHP. Now coming to the arrays, so similarly, PHP supports the same style of your C programming language array style, but you can use the keyword array followed by a set of values here. And you can access that particular array using what are the name of the array you have used, and you can display the corresponding value. So I can you can use either subscripts with the name of that particular array, or you can simply directly assign the values. So you can either way, you can use those particular arrays to store certain values onto your variables of your program. And you can, if you want to use a multi-dimensional array, PHP supports, you can declare the array consisting of two different levels, such as student one is again array, which itself the student one contains the data which is related to the student one, and student two is also a sub-array. So both the student one sub-array and the student two sub-array, both the sub-arrays are been again associated with another array called marks. So here, whenever you are going to look for a particular value of a particular student, you can use the corresponding indexes, or you can use the corresponding referencing with the corresponding names of those sub-arrays. So here in this example, you are displaying the marks of student one physics. So the echo statement will give the marks of the student one's physics, that is the value 35. So we'll make a note here. These are the values that are being given with the arrow mark. So this arrow mark indicates that this particular attribute physics contains this particular values. So this is how you can define your multi-dimensional arrays using your PHP. Now coming to functions, the same principles of the C programming language functions, like functions, you need not specify the written data types, or you not specify the data types of the parameters that you are going to use it in your program. So you can invoke the function, like you can define the function within the PHP scripts tags. So your function add function has been defined with the two arguments, $num1 and $num2, which are getting the values from the function which has been called within the PHP itself. So these variables are referring to the values 10 and 20, and the corresponding value has been displayed when this particular function add function has been invoked here. Similarly, this function can return a single value. So the return value can also be stored into a temporary value. There's written value, and that particular value can also be displayed. Similar, all these things which are very much similar to C programming language style functions. So you are embedding those PHP statements within the body tag of your PHP. Then the most important things, now the importance of PHP comes with the super global variables. So whenever you are using variables here, if they are normally preceded or normally prefixed with dollar symbol, these are the user defined variables. So like this $sum, $num1, $num2, these are all user defined variables. Whereas you can see that $_ followed by capital letters get. So $_ capital letters post, $_ session, $_ cookies, $_ your HTTP protocol, so on and so forth. These are all, whenever a variable or your certain functions names, you can see with preceded with dollar followed by underscore symbol, which implies that these are the global variables which are going to be referred to a reference to some other values which need to be picked up from the client side or from your on the server from another source. So something like this. Example, we'll start with $_ get form element name. Usually whenever you design your web pages, you may be using the form tag, a form tag. So inside the form tag, you are going to use an attribute with $_ get. So it is used to collect value from a form sent with the method get. So information is sent from a form with the method get, and it is visible to everyone. So here, if you are using post, the post, this is a difference between get and a post. Get method, whenever you use get method or your get variable $_ get super global variable, that get method or your get function will tell us or give us, or it is, the values are visible to the user, whereas $_ post method will not, the values will not be visible to the user during the navigation from one web page to another web page. So it is invisible, so you cannot show this one. So let us see with an example how to use the get and the post methods. So here in this small example here, form method post. So you are defining a form tag within your HTML page, and you are using a table tag to define a row here, tr, as well as the table row consists of enter the first number. Similarly, there is another row here containing of enter the second number. So the data elements of the first row contains the label like enter first number and the text box, and the name of the text box is fm. Similarly, the second row consists of a label enter second number, and there is another data element of your second row of the table, which is a text box type, and the name of the text box is SN, second name, first name and the second name. So here you are defining two rows, that is a column span with two values, and you are giving a submit button so that user can click the submit button. Once the user clicks the submit button, so that submit button name, this basically is a type submit button, but the name of the submit button is, we are giving something like a swap. So what does this swap is going to do? So whenever user clicks, whenever the event is happening here, so some event method is been written in the PHP script. So the server side PHP script does something like this. So whenever there is a post, it is given method post here. So the dollar post is set, it means it is inactivated. Then again, you need to look for whether the button has been clicked by the user. If is set is a function which tells us that this dollar of dollar swap that is equivalent to your button name, which has been clicked by the user, that has been set on. So what is that you're doing? Your first name is being transferred to another variable X. Second name is being transferred to another variable Y. And the third variable Z is being initialized with zero or something like this. You can number or name, whatever you like to have, you can use it, the characters. But here I'm giving that you are going to swap two numbers here. So the first FN stands for first numbers, SN stands for second number here. So the dollar X values temporarily move to dollar Z, then the dollar Y is moved to dollar X, then the dollar Z is moved to dollar Y, which using the temporary variable. You have been swapping the numbers from the first number box to the second number box. So that's what, when the user clicks the submit button, the numbers are being swapped from one box to another box. So these are, you can use this particular dollar underscore post, which implies that the post method, the once the user clicks that particular button, the post web page method gets executed here, that post web page method, which implies that is a logic which you are written here to swap two numbers here. So in the next video, we'll see how we can make use of MySQL so that you can build up a small web application for a user login system. That we'll see it in the next video. Thank you. And the reference book we are going to follow for this particular thing is on the book is available on the our university library website. So you can download the book. So this is a PHP reference, beginner to intermediate PHP version 5. So this will is basically a Creative Commons attribution license is given here. You can make use of this one. So most of the contents have been taken from this particular book. So kindly refer to this book. It will be a quick, handy book for you to refer to various PHP functions. Thank you. We'll see it in the next demo video for the user login system.